Hi there, I'm back with a final video on variation, and in this video we are going to talk about joint variation and combined variation. These should not take quite as much time because they are built on what we've already studied. We've looked at direct variation, where y is equal to k times x, where k is our constant of proportionality, and inverse variation, where y is equal to k over x, and where k is again this constant of proportionality. And remember, direct variation is when both variables increase or decrease together. Indirect variation, as one variable gets bigger, the other one gets smaller. Then joint variation is when we have more than two variables that are related directly. So it's really kind of the same idea as direct variation, but there's just more than two variables. Rather than just y and x as variables, there's going to be y, x, and maybe z or w or something else for a variable. It will still have this constant of proportionality involved in it. And then a combined variation is a situation that includes both inverse and either direct or joint variation. So we have joint variation could look something like this: y is equal to k, our constant, times x times z. That's just an example. There's many, many different things that could be involved with a joint variation. And similarly with the combined variation, y is equal to k times w, that's the direct variation part of it, and over x, that is the inverse variation part of a combined. I think the best way to go through this is to just work through a few examples of joint and combined variation. So we have here lateral surface area of a cylinder. Remember, lateral surface area does not include the circle on the top or the circle on the bottom. So it's just looking at this like if you think of it as a soup can, it's the label of the soup can is your lateral surface area. So we've got the lateral surface area of the cylinder varies jointly as its radius and height. So jointly, and it's going to be the lateral surface area, so we'll call that L. The lateral surface area varies jointly, so it equals K, and then radius and height are the two variables. So K times radius times height. So L is equal to KRH. Now this constant, if you think back to what you know about this formula for the surface area of a cylinder, if we were to take this soup label and spread it out, we would have a rectangle where we've got our height. And then this distance here is actually the circle. It's the distance around the cylinder. And that distance is the circumference of our circle. And the circumference of our circle is 2 pi r. So if we plug that in to what we have 2 pi is the constant part of this, because 2 pi is approximately 6.28. the radius times the height. So if we wanted to get it down to an exact formula for the lateral surface area, 2 pi RH, and that is written as a joint variation. But it took some background knowledge to figure out what the K is. There's not information directly in the problem for us to solve K. Next problem. Suppose that y varies directly as the square of x. So I'm going to stop right there. So y varies directly, so that's k times x squared. So varies directly as the square of x. So because there are two x's, x times x, this is a joint variation problem. So this is our formula. Y is equal to k times x squared. If y is 24 when x is 2, so we have y is 24, so we can plug that in. 24 is equal to k times 2 squared. Because x is 2, we plug that in. We get 24 is equal to 4 times k, because 2 squared is 4. divide each side by 4, and we get 6 is equal to k. So my constant of variation is k. The variation equation then would be y is equal to 6x squared. And that would be a joint variation given to you with x being the variable used 2 times. And finally, we have here a combined variation. So we've got the maximum weight that a circular column can support is directly proportional to the fourth power of its diameter. Okay, so we've got directly proportional to the fourth power of its diameter. So let's just stop right there. So let's call this maximum weight W. Let's call the diameter D. Square of its height, we'll call that H. So we've got the maximum weight, W, is directly proportional, so that would be K times the fourth power of its diameter, so D to the fourth. And is inversely proportional, so that means we have to write it over. It's inversely proportional to the square of its height. So that means it's height squared. So that would be our formula for this combined variation. Now, backtracking just a little bit here. With our inverse and direct variation, with a direct variation, we said we could solve this using a proportion. And our inverse variation, we said we could solve using a product idea where x1 times y1 is equal to x2 and y times y2. So we had those for direct and inverse variations. When you get to joint and combined variations, it's too complex to try and come together with proportions and products. It's easiest just to say, let's take the formula for joint variation and go with it. In this case, take the formula for your combined variation, go with it, plug in what you know, find your constant of variation, and then solve. So this is our picture of what we have. We have our cylinder columns. 2 meters is the diameter, 8 meter height, and then we have a 1 meter diameter with a 4 meter height. And what we want to find out is we want to find the weight that a 1 meter diameter column that is 4 meters high can support. So in order to solve this, the first thing we have to do is find the k based on, that's a horrible star, but you get the idea. Let's try that again. That's a little bit better. Still not very good. But based on this larger column, because they give us enough information. So the maximum weight is 1 ton. So W is 1 ton. Is equal to K times the diameter is 2. So that's 2 to the fourth power over the height, which is 8 to the second power. So we have 1 is equal to 2 to the fourth power, 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 is 16. And 8 to the second power is 64. So we solve this, multiply both sides by 64, and we get 64 is equal to 16k. Divide both sides by 16, and we get 4 is equal to k. So that is our constant of variation. Now that we have our constant of variation, we can use that in combined with this smaller column, and we can say W, which we want to find, is equal to our constant of variation, 4 times D squared over H squared. And that's our formula. We can just plug in what we know. W is equal to 4 times the diameter, in this case, is 1, and the height is 4. So W is equal to 4 times 1 squared is 1, so that's 4 over 4 times 4 is 16. So W is equal to 4 over 16, reduce that fraction to be 1/4. And our unit here for the weight is 1/4 of a ton, because that's what our initial weight was. So our smaller column can hold 1/4 of a ton. So that's really it for these joint variation type problems. You just got to read through the problem, directly proportional, write that part on the top, however it's worded. Inversely proportional, you write that at the bottom of your fraction. Go through with the information that they give you, solve for your k value. Once you find your k, you have your equation that you can use to solve your problem. Good luck.